Today's date is March 4th, 2021.
This is brought to you by
Omkar
and Zuhair.
Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic of which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please be seated. Today's animal review is the moon bear. The moon bear, also known as the Asian black bear, is one of the largest bears known to man. They have a white crescent shape on their chest, and they are one of the nicer bears, but they can attack when provoked. Ladies and gentlemen, that is the moon bear.
For lunch today, we have a choice of chicken and waffle, hot dog on bun, and chicken garden salad.
Sides include sweet potato tots, baked beans, mixed up fruit cup, and fresh fruit.
This week we'll be celebrating Decade Day.
Now to Mr. Gamble for the rest of the announcements.
Good morning, Hawks. Thursday, you know, more than halfway past the week. Thursday, March the 4th here, and lots of great stuff going on. Of course, yesterday, we had our basketball playoffs, and I'm recording this before our games. So hopefully we have happy news to share and find out if our teams are moving on. Girls played High Springs, boys played Kanapaha. So at the time of this recording, games haven't been played yet. However, do have to give a special Hawk shout out to our two super fan teachers, Ms. Yancey and Mr. Kalishman, who come to every single game. They even go to all the away games, even there in Hawthorne. Ms. Yancey and Mr. Kalishman will drive out there and show support for our team. So big shout out to them for always being there through thick and thin, giving them support. And of course, this year when we couldn't allow many people into the gym, they came and they would stand the whole game on the sidelines cheering on our teams. And again, thank you for your support. And I hope you students tell them thanks for coming out to all of our games, Ms. Yancey and Mr. Kalishman. Of course, we've got our great coaches, Coach Laris, Coach Moore, Coach Curtis, that helps out all the time too. And Ms. Brown, who's always there making sure we're taking the tickets and getting things in the books properly. So well done, and thanks for your total support all the time. Okay, and soccer season's getting geared up too. The games won't start until after we come back from spring break, March 29th, but our teams are already practicing. Coach Gunther with the boys team, and we have Coach Carr coaching the girls. They had the additional hardship of having to travel back over by Howard Bishop to the Citizens Park there, the big fields next to Northeast Pool, to practice soccer. And it's kind of cool that we'll be playing our games at Citizens Field. So we'll have a good venue for that where the high school teams play. So will Westwood, because guess what? Our school is on top of Westwood soccer field. A lot of people forget how much Westwood sacrificing for us to get our brand new school built, but they are. So if you know anybody at Westwood, tell them thanks a lot for that, because we really appreciate it, and they've been terrific neighbors. Moving on, tomorrow we're having a spirit day, which, gosh, I keep forgetting to promote, and it's Decade Day, one of the most fun ones. Now, most of we adults here on campus spent most of our years in the 20th century in those decades, so everybody thinks about the 1950s and, you know, those kind of fashions, or if you had some leftover polyester, the 1970s. I got some goofy 80s shirts, you know, new wave stuff. And here we are in the third decade of the 21st century already. Boy, does time fly. But, you know, I don't know, you know, what's a distinctive style from the early 2000s or from 2010 to 2019, right? I don't know. So surprises. But again, those are the traditional things, so we'll have some fun with that. Decades Day tomorrow on Friday. Students, thanks for doing a good job of being good neighbors at the park. And we need to be good while we're here on campus, too. Unfortunately, on Wednesday, seventh graders, you left the mess outside of the tables for lunch, and then all ran down the park and left the mess there. Not cool at all. So sorry, seventh grade, you guys are not going down to the park today. You know, when you don't hold up your end of the bargain, you don't get the privileges of going down to the park. Eighth grade, good job. Sixth graders, we let you come down to the park. You guys got to be a little more chill before we leave for the park, okay? Eat your lunch, be chill. We'll take you down to the park, but no running around acting like you're in the park here at school. Got it? Good. Right. Remember, let's be kind always. It's the right thing to do. Oh, I need to put in another plug about leave masks alone at the bus stop. Little game being played about snapping other people's masks off. Not cool at all. You see that, you're going to be in lunch detention for a while every single lunch day. So leave other people's masks alone. Got it? Good. So that's all a part of being kind. Be kind all the time. Work hard each and every one of your classes, all 50 minutes. Finally, give someone a compliment during the day. When you receive a compliment, look that person in the eye and say thank you. Let's have a thrilling Thursday, Hawks. Ciao.
There have been many women in history that have changed things for the better, like Michelle Obama, Jane Austen, and many more. One person has stood out.
Ruth Bader Ginsburg was born on March 15, 1933 in Brooklyn, New York. Her childhood was not an easy one. Her parents both grew very sick when she was only 14 months old. Then her sister passed away from meningitis when Ruth was only 6 years old. Ruth did many things to help equality and fairness in our country, and it all started when she was appointed.
In 1980, Ruth Bader Ginsburg was appointed to be a U.S. court judge by President Bill Clinton. From there, things started looking up for women, who at the time were being treated and paid a lot less than men.
A well-known case from her was the Duren versus Missouri case. The Missouri state law at the time permitted women over 65 to be exempted from the jury duty upon request.
Women who failed to show up for jury duty were automatically exempted in Taylor, Louisiana. The Supreme Court held that symptomatic exclusion of women from the jury pool resulted in jury pools that are not representative of the general population.
Ruth wanted equality and justice for all. In many cases, she stood up for what was right and equal.
Ruth sadly passed away September 18th, 2020 from many different cancers. Rest in peace, Ruth.
This month is Women's History Month. Please look out for special features about different special women during Women's History Month.
Looking for a good book? Check out our virtual book fair at efairs.folletbookfairs.com. School code is WRXKD. Find your books, place the order, and the books will be delivered to you at home. You get something great to read, and we get funds to buy more books for our library. For more information, contact Ms. Cole.
Have a great day.
Go Hawks!
Thank you.